So I'm listening to this from the gunner who's usually standing in the back and look over the entire gun crew and make sure everyone has the implements and the tools they need in order to do this job. Okay? Watch the cover. Number three is going to step up and take a brush and clean out the vent hole at the back of the cannon. This is where we fire the cannon from, so we want to make sure that vent hole is clean and nice and clean. Right? Number three will then cover the hole with their thumb. The thumb has a little leather piece over it called a thumb stall. They cover that. The thumb stall is keep from getting burned on the cannon when it gets hot. But the reason that we cover that up, I'll explain in a minute or two. Worm! Number two goes in with the worm. Look, basically you can say a corkscrew on the end of a long stick. The idea here is to hook any remnants of the last round that we fired to clean the gun out. After we fire, when he does it for the next shot, you'll notice that we pull out a chunk of aluminum foil. They did not have aluminum foil during the Civil War. And we use aluminum foil because it's a really easy thing to use. Question? Absolutely. All right, that was an easy question. Okay. Fun! Number one goes in with the wet sponge. The idea here is to put out any embers that might be glowing from the last time we fired. You can imagine if there's a little flame or a glowing ember and then we load the next gunpowder bag, it's gonna go off all by itself. Now, between the sponge being wet and tight fitting in the bore, and number three sealing off the vent, we also, not only is the sponge wet, we also seal off there's no oxygen left in the barrel. So it's kind of a two-step process to put that any flame or ember out. Wet, plus it runs out of oxygen and it can't burn anything. Okay? If you didn't cover the bag and you did that with the sponge, it'd be almost like a blacksmith's bellows. It would just be sucking the air in and blowing out, and the thing would blow even more. So we want to make sure it gets put out. You'll see it when number two turned, after we've done with the worm, he turned, put his hands on the wheel. Alright? He's ready to receive the round. The reason he puts his hands on the wheel, this is a metal-rimmed wheel. So now he's grounded himself, all right? Static electricity and gunpowder don't mix well together, all right? So we don't really want the first sergeant to go boom. Most of the time we don't want to. All right? Advance the round. Number five comes up, shows the gunner the round. Show him that he actually had the right one that he asked for, all right? He returned. Hands it around to the number two man. Number two, again, shields that. They both shield that round as much as possible. If I have a sniper over here, okay, and they shoot that gunpowder bag, it explodes and kills the whole crew. If he shoots number two or number five, I can replace them. That's just the way it is, all right? Number five has delivered the round. He gets out of the way. He's done with his new Civil War. Ram! Number one now is to ram that charge, if we're firing a cannonball, all the way to the back of the gun. Right? Get it to the breech loader, you load it from the front, so we have to ram that all the way to the back. I know some of you watched the infantry demonstration a little while ago when they used a ramrod. Same idea, except on a bigger scale. You'll see the number one man has put the rammer up on the hub of the wheel. This is the only thing that they did not do during the Civil War. We do it as a safety feature because it shows other reenactors we have a loaded cannon. You can see that from a long way across the field. But they did not do that during the Civil War. Prime! Oh, wait. Missed a step. Gunner now will aim the gun. You can change the elevation by turning the elevating screw in the back. You can see I can change which way, how high or low the artillery shoots. If I want to change which way it's aiming, I will tap the trail one way or the other as I sight. And the number three literally has to pick up the back of the cannon and move it until I'm satisfied. That's the way you aim a Civil War cannon. You literally pick the cannon up and move the back of it until it's aiming in the right direction.
Yeah, I'll get them.
You guys gotta shift back over a little bit more, right? Because you don't want to be in front of the barrel when it goes off. Okay. Prime. Number three takes a brass spike. We use brass so it doesn't make a spark. Punches a hole in the gunpowder bag. Number four will answer. Prime. Prime basically is a little brass tube with a wire attached. Inside the brass tube, there's a small explosive charge. When you yank on the wire, it ignites that explosive charge, sends a flame down into the gunpowder bag, and the cannon sets off just like that. At least that's the way it's supposed to be. Okay? Every once in a while you get a dud, but that's exactly the same way as they did it during Civil War. No difference. Okay? Very well. Now you guys might want to do a little bit physical.